the captain. My name is Colin Billingmore. On behalf of Caledonia and McRae and the crew, I'd like to welcome you aboard the Clantron for this sailing today. First to Col and then on to Oban. Loading has now been completed and all car deck doors are closed and secure, and the ship will be leaving shortly. The weather is good for sailing today, the wind is southeasterly force 4. Please be reminded we have an Oxford Airlines.
Skipper, this is Skipper. Look at the power to the bit board about dashing 13. And it's just a bit awkward to do this. May I have your attention, ladies and gentlemen? Please listen very carefully to the following safety alert.
This is going in shortly. Look, there's some passengers, please
We know who's on the island. That's one thing the causeway has done. It's created employment for the island by the access of going to the appointment. You can come and go in the morning if you want to go early. And like there are some lorry drivers and some people like that working in news. They can go in the morning, they can come back at night.
Again, to get your messages from the co-op, you would get have a car maybe on the other side, and then you would take the car to the co-op and get your messages, put them in the car, then come out at Newton Ferry, take all your messages out, put them into the boat, then take them out of the boat. You know, just the general convenience, instead of coming down to the whole boat, and especially when it was just the passenger.
Just open the place out completely.
Og ég dóa ekki í minni að Kristján enda í umvæk og fyrirskort. Ég sann svo hérna og ég kom að hvíða inn í dungin ekki sem að hoskja á ég með herra mólk.
I've just walked out to the sea across the Salas Manca.
The Macher is where it's sandy out on the west side.
This is the bent grass. This is the grass that goes on the Macher.
The Macher is
people use
where it's sandy on the west side.
Да, они рекро и все туго, ну, что... Сабош на есть, а я вот двух.
There's long strips across, heading down to the beach, which have all got lovely cows on them.
All the cows, maybe they're patches from the map.
Cattle,
the old days, cultivated.
Yeah.
You know, this is all sort of famous.
Before that, everybody would have their a couple of cows, chickens,
of barley
the sheep, and so on, planting crops, turnips are quite famous. Not a big plant. No one is
everybody
relying on the team to see this
it sort of died out completely,
but in the last couple of years it's started to
go. In the olden days,
planting and so on, planting crops,
So
what's been sighted recently are corncrake, corn buntings, white turnstone, sandling, dunlin, bird-tailed corn codlet,
By the late 1840s, mainly due to a decrease in the market price of kelp and potato crop failure, the tenants of these townships found it difficult or were unable to pay rents, which had risen sharply in the years.
back with Derek and I knew. Fine. I was...
Man would go out to the croft and feed the sheep and he'd shear them or whatever, and then you'd take them in and the woman would, you'd do whatever with the bull or... the sheep cast ewes £4 a kilo. So you're looking at maybe 50-60 kilos. You're getting absolutely peanuts for your number. Lambs.
Who buys them?
Range between.
Who are these people buying?
Five.
And they buy the lambs. Most of them ready for kill. Some of them the store.
Okay. Right. And they take them all over on the ferry. Yes. Yeah.
Range between five and 25 pounds. And when you see the prices you pay in the supermarkets, you know, when the butcher or something like that, you pay almost a pound for a chew.
Yeah, two townships,
sustained hundreds of thousands of families.
By the late 1840s, mainly due to the market price of pulp and potato crop failure, the tenants of these townships found it difficult or were unable to pay rent, which had risen sharply. With the intention of letting Dunskeller and Solis sink on profitable farm, Lord MacDonald and his agents
sustained hundreds of thousands of families.
One of his principal representatives in the leading perpetrator of the clearance, James MacDonald of Balranald, was the first to hold what was now called the Farm of Solis. This area used to be occupied by successive farms until 1898, when, along with the adjacent farm of Gully Tote, it was broken into crops by the congested district school. Around us, the Solis landscape provides a heritage of ruined houses and fallen dykes. Poignant and permanent memorial to 19th century feudal oppression and emigration. As a new millennium approaches, the heritage of a displaced people is descendants and scattered throughout
the world. Hij had nog een gewoon een persoon ogen en die iets knap aan daar is en ik het ogen en niet meer. Hij was... Ik weet niet hoe ze zijn met de jongen.
Two women were sent off to learn the weaving, to a course, a weaving course, and they came back and taught.
That's too much.
Ready? Ready? Natural.
Yep. Yes. push it right in, push it right into the box. Right in. That's it. That's it. That'll do it.
Okay.
Right, right. Oh, oh no. That's a bit too hard. Right. Much too slow. Much too slow. Right. Oh, oh no. That's a bit too hard. Right. Much too slow. Much too slow. Right. Oh, oh no. That's a bit too hard. Right.
The islands shipped away,
to be graded, and then when it's graded we buy part of the wool grows, the grade we buy, and then, so it's partly from this island.
We don't weave for the marriage, we just weave for ourselves.
Then goes into one of these vents.
22 meters of vents here.
This pipe is spinning. Just makes in the
spinning.
Then gets another mix, passing it into the other. Then back.
You wouldn't have to be a weaver.
That's not too hard.
You only make their own for their own use until one estate owner in Harris took a few samples to London, and that's how it started. Okay. She came back with orders for more and more and more, for more and more and more, for more and more and more, for more and more.
For it to be Harris tweed, it has to be pedal, 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 pedal.
Threw the shuttle back and then she had to throw it back, pull it back and forwards. Yes. Because the these ones are automatic. We have that's the only these ones, the thing comes forward, you see, to pull the threads. It can't be electrically powered, it has to be hand woven still on that foot. But yes, I mean, they have to throw it across, pull this forward, throw it back, pull this forward with the other hand, throw it across, pull this forward, throw it back. Pull this forward, pull this forward, throw it back, throw it across, pull this forward, throw it back, 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 pull this forward, pull this forward, throw it back, pull this forward, throw it across, pull this forward, throw it back, pull this forward, throw it back.
Well, the older machines, they were big, huge wooden frames. They had four pedals, and you had to pull this in with your hand and shoot this across with the other hand and You wash both feet and both feet and both hands.
This does the same thing, only it's what all the machine is worth from these two pedals.
only go to that blue one. There, go to that barns.
Further out than and stay overnight. They would drop the anchors maybe in a bay after their fishing, and the two boats would be conversing with each other, you know, just talking to each other.
Almost always towards the highest bidder.
Shouting or whatever. And
she opened the door at the bottom there, there's two sections
where they would gather. And the second
one for the rest of the continent. On farm market. Working something like 750-800 farm fields a day. Lobster,
every couple of years you get a whale.
Mm-hmm. Somebody would start singing a song, mm-hmm. and everybody would join in. Mm-hmm. You could just hear the music that they're singing going into the disc.
And having to carry the camp, which in those days was anything like 10 to 13 boxes from ashore up to the sea.
The camps were sold entirely locally, but not all to local buyers. Some local, some from England. But at the end of the day, the produce always ended up on the whole ends up on the continent. The cat's keep throwing a lobster, scab, whatever, he was always sold locally. Although sometimes, it wasn't always a local buyer. Several buyers came up from the mainland to buy the catches. And I think the highest side, probably beginning and the end of the season. In particular, the price would drop quite massively, in particular the beginning of July, at which time it was very difficult to store lobsters because of the certain height of the summer. It was difficult to store, and if the season was really good, you would have to sell at a much lower price than you would get in July.
Plenty of fresh fish here. Plenty of, well, they eat a lot of the birds, the ducks, the wild ducks, the wild geese, the wild, and they always have plenty of potatoes.
Thank you.
Good morning.
Psalm 86, the 86th Psalm, and we will sing from verse 8, sorry, this is in the Scottish Psalter, H341. Thank you.
if we had been to stay, see the mercy, the grace, and the passion. Lord's mercy, side by side with that, it is compared with me, own act of what we have, that we have messers, and we have creatures. Watch over us all, Lord, keep us all sweet, keep us all. Restoring me.